Hello everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we talked about event driven architecture. So in this video we are just going to combine all the things and we will just talk a little bit about each and every pattern. So these are different patterns which are available in the microservices.net. This is a website which talks about lot about microservices. So I extracted the information from there only. So what all different microservice pattern we have, those are divided into the multiple categories: cross-cutting concerns, observability pattern, database pattern, integration pattern, and decomposition pattern. So what we will do, we'll talk about each and every one a little bit, and then in the actual implementation we will talk about them. Okay, so first of all is a decomposition pattern. So here we are doing a decomposition of microservices based on the business capability. So microservices is all about microservices loosely coupled, applying the single responsibility principle. So we have to see the business capability. Okay, can we just create a separate microservice? That is decided by the business capability and business architecture modeling. It says that, okay, let's create a order management is responsible for order, customer management is responsible for customer. Or you can also do a decomposition by subdomain. Decomposition application using business capabilities might be a good start, but you can also decompose the applications by the domain. So that comes like a domain driven design, where you are actually going to create a subdomain for a particular services. A domain is consist of multiple subdomain, and each subdomain corresponds to a different part of business, like helloworld.com. that a.helloworld.com can be pointing to another microservice and doing a different part of the business. Then we have like these subdomains can be a different for the order management system. One is a product catalog service, inventory management, delivery management, customer management. These can be a subdomain on the root service. Decomposition by transaction. This is okay. You can decompose services over the transactions. So there may be a particular transaction can be split into the two parts: prepare phase and the commit and rollback phase. During prepare phase, all the participants of the transaction prepare and commit, notify the coordinate that we are ready to persist the transaction. So commit and rollback phase, during this phase either a commit or a rollback command is issued by the transaction coordinator. So it's like you are splitting the transaction into two parts and trying to deal with that. Then other is a strangler pattern and all, we'll not go into much deep. Now integration patterns, which are like API gateway pattern which we see. So why we need API gateway? So there are multiple calls happening to multiple microservices through a different channel. There is need to be a single point of contact for all the microservices, and microservices internally can talk to each other, right? So an API gateway is a single point of entry point for microservices call. It can work as a proxy services to route a request to the concerned microservices. It can aggregate the result and send back to the customer. Now you can have n number of microservices after API gateway. They can talk and they can give you the response. It can also convert the protocol request response, all the things. Aggregator pattern, in the integration pattern. So when breaking the business functionality into smaller logical pieces, we try to have different microservices, right? And now we want to compose the data. A composite microservice will make a call to the required microservice, consolidate the data, and will send back. So it's very simple. From the name, it's clear. Aggregator means it is aggregating the data and giving the response back. So an API gateway can also partition the request of multiple microservices and aggregate them and aggregate them before sending it to the customer. Proxy pattern. Okay, so like API gateway, we just expose a microservices our API gateway. Other than that, we can also create a different kind of a gateway. Like you can also create a proxy pattern, which is just putting a one proxy in our application gateway. Okay, proxy pattern is just about creating a one proxy layer on top of our API gateway, just for security concerns sometimes you have. Gateway routing pattern, this is about API gateway routing which we can have. So API gateway is responsible for request routing. An API gateway implements some API operations, and based on the route coming at the API gateway, we send that, we map those requests to a particular set of microservices. So we create a routing map. Okay, this service, this route go to this service go to that service. So this function is kind of identical to our reverse proxy mechanism using Nginx. Okay, it's do the same thing. like chained microservice pattern, there will be a multiple dependency on a single service. We should try to avoid it where one service is getting the data from multiple service and one service is talking to another and another is talking to third service, and then after the communication happens, they are sending back the response. Okay, now the database pattern, database per service, all these decisions. Okay, do you want a database per service? Can we have a, we should always try that the microservices should have their own data source, means database. Service must be loosely coupled, they can be deployed, scaled independently. So in that case, you should have an independent data source for a particular service. To achieve a highly decoupled application, one database per microservice should be designed by default. It must be private to the service only. It should be accessed by the microservice APIs only. It can't be accessed by other microservice directly. Shared database, once you have like, okay, Redis has a cache and two microservices wanted to check, okay, Redis has that key or not. In that case, the Redis or a database can be shared between the smaller microservices we wanted to have. Command query, CQRS is another popular term, or event sourcing. So once we implement a database per service, there is a requirement to query which require a joint data from multiple services. It's not possible, right? Because there are two services, we are talking to a data source independently. So CQRS suggests splitting the application into two parts, the command side and the query side. So the command side handles the create, update, delete request, and the query side handles the query part by using the materialized view. So the event sourcing pattern is generally used along with to create an event for any data change, and this materialized view second part is kept updated by subscribing to the set of events. So first, in the first set, we are just doing a create, update, delete, and the second set we are just making an event and we are subscribing to that event to update the data. Okay, and we have event sourcing. Most of the application works with the data and typically approach for the application maintain the current source. Okay, so what we do in the microservices, we are running the CRUD operations. So event sourcing pattern define an approach to handle the operations on the data driven sequence. So event sourcing, different events are coming in a particular order, so we will be processing them and they will change the state in that particular order only. Like you add item into the cart, so cart created, item 1 added, item 2 added, item 1 removed, shipping information added. So all these events should go in a particular sequence, right? So this can be handled through the event sourcing pattern with the CQRS, where we are just splitting the query with the actual execution. Okay, query and materialized view. Okay, so all these saga patterns and all are the same. Observability pattern is all about log aggregation, performance metrics, distributed tracing, health check of a different microservice APIs. Cross-cutting concerns are all about externalizing configurations, okay, or external configurations, whatever the configurations we have for different environments. So we can externalize the configuration so the applications can be deployed independently by accessing the configurations. So to avoid a code modifications for these different configurations while deploying it to dev, QA, stage environment, we can have a service accordingly. Service discovery pattern, when microservice come into the picture, we need to address a few issues. Okay, so what all those? With the container technologies, IP address, which are getting allocated dynamically in the Kubernetes, each service had some URL or each service had some identifier. So what we can do is we should be using some kind of a service discovery mechanism or service registry mechanism so that we can identify where that service is. We should be able to register that, okay, this is the only service allowed to talk to this. So this can be happen at the client side and server side. So service registry need to be created, which will kept the metadata of each producer service and specification of each services. Okay, you can also deregister by when the service is shut down, then it will deregister. In that case, you will not be talking. You know, okay, this service registry knows there is no particular service to respond for a particular request. Okay, all the other things we will just talk one by one. All the deployment patterns like blue-green deployment. So there are n number of deployment patterns in the microservice world when it comes to deploying an application without having a downtime. Okay, That we will talk about it. So, I mean, it is just a theoretical. I also have a blog which I will share on this about all the microservice pattern we have, which are divided into these five major categories. And what we always see in the application development, we see the event-driven architecture with the CQRS and event sourcing. And with the simple microservice, we will see an API gateway. Or when we have a complex services, then we might introduce a service discovery pattern where services are getting discovered through service registry. API gateway routing can happen on the AWS, Azure, both provides an API gateway implementation. Okay, thanks everyone.